Hello, my name is Kerry Ellis, and I'm probably most known for painting myself green and being Elphaba in Wicked. I've done endless musicals in the West End, Les Miserables, We Will Rock You, lots of musical theatre singing. So today I'm going to talk about a little bit how we sing in musical theatre, a bit of acting through song, a little bit actually how a musical theatre voice is, or how mine is. Touch me, it's so easy to leave me. Musical theatre is all about acting through song. A song is just an extension of the scene. So I always try and learn the lyrics and the text first and make it work as a piece of dialogue. And then I add the voice. The music will move you. And that's the beauty of it. You're making people feel something. It's like when you go and see a film and you might not be aware of it, but the music underneath will make you feel something. And that's the same as a musical. So there's lots of different types of voices in musical theatre because there's lots of different characters. There are those big kind of belty songs that I would sing, like Elphaba.
And if I'm flying solo, at least I'm flying free.
And another one would be I Dreamed a Dream from Les Miserables.
I dreamed a dream in time gone by.
But there's also kind of that kind of speak-singing style, like Jonathan Pryce did. I did My Fair Lady with him at Drury Lane, which was an unbelievable experience. And he did this song called I'm Just an Ordinary Man. And he kind of spoke sung it, which kind of means he speaks the lyrics, but in tune. And it is so powerful. It blew my mind, but it also gave me a lot of, it gave me ideas how to use my voice and how I don't need to sing everything all the time. And I could kind of speak some of those lyrics. Also, Judy Dench does it. She sings Sending the Clowns, and it is magical. There's also people like sopranos, Phantom of the Opera, Think of Me, those beautiful soprano notes. She does that lovely big riff at the end, which is amazing. There's altos, there's basses, and then there's boys that they do all different things. So I don't know what the boys do. I'm probably a mezzo soprano. I kind of sit between both areas. I'm an alto sound, but I can also belt quite high, so I'm kind of in the middle. But I guess I'm technically a mezzo soprano. You're not up there with the sopranos, you're not singing all the Think of Me, that all of those lovely high scales, so you can kind of belt up there and mix and go slightly higher. There are lots of different qualities with musical theatre singers. People have all these different little styles and tweaks that they do. I kind of have this thing called a growl. Some of you may know it. It first appeared in No One But You and We Will Rock You. There's a bit when it goes, there's a face at the window. And I kind of got a growl in there. I don't really know how it happened. I don't know where it came from, but it became my thing. I then went on to use it in Wicked, and it popped in now and again. In the last little bit of Defying Gravity, of Lord to the Western Sky, I kind of put this growl in, and it didn't wreck my voice, but I think if I overdid it, it would lose the impact for starters, and also I think it would damage my voice. So if you try a growl, just make sure you're safe and make sure you sit back on it, you don't push it.
So if you care to find me, look to the Western Sky. As someone told me lately, everyone deserves a chance to fly.
I personally have several different parts to my voice. So there's the big, strong, belty bits. I Dreamed a Dream when you do the shame. That's a nice, big, belty sound. It's a full sound. But then there's also the more delicate In For Good. It's a very soft, it's almost spoken. It's a bit more gentle. It's not as full. It's a lot more relaxed. I feel my body completely relaxed when I sing quieter, when it's a bit more tender, when you're speaking. And there's this mix moment. It's a mix of both voices, and it goes through from the gentle to the belt. In a song like I Dreamed a Dream, there's a wonderful moment, but the tigers come at night as they tear your hope apart. It gets quite dark and you start getting a bit more, you've been quite soft up until this moment, and it's a good gear change.
As they turn your dream to shame.